A 16-minute victory for TNC in game number one. Looking to be able to make this a very clean 2-0 against Team Rave, the other opposing Filipino team in this quarterfinal matchup. Determine who's going to be going into the semifinals. Of course, all these matches are elimination matches as well. Something to keep in mind for the ESL 1 Frankfurt qualifier. As you go into game number two now, welcome back, Mott Pax, my co-caster.
Hey, you.
I love that name.
Yeah, it's good stuff. So this time, things are a little bit different. Rave are taking kind of a like a play out of TNC's book last time. Like, whereas opened up with the like Faceless Void and the OD for Rave, and that right away just kind of gave away everything. So I think this time they're looking to be a little bit more reactive, kind of the way that we had like a Nature's Prophet, obviously core hero for Sam H, and then just the Witch Doctor. This time they're once again going to take that Witch Doctor nice and early, set up with the OD. But Rave aren't committing two cores early on in the draft. I'm going to go for this Vengeful Spirit. And I think the Chen ban out also pretty solid here, along with the Enchantress. So they're looking for some of those typical TNC heroes. Kind of interesting that they did go with that first ban out on the Nature's Prophet themselves. And really worried about handing that over to the side of Rappy, it seems.
Meanwhile, Rave going to ban away all the pushing heroes. As many as they possibly can. TNC, though, not really looking for a pushing lineup this time around, it seems. They get the OD Witch Doctor very clearly. You want to be able to make sure the Faceless Void doesn't fall into the hands of TNC. Rave could have banned it away, but they chose to grab it themselves.
I think this is what TNC wanted, though. Like, with the ban on the Nature's Prophet. I think they were kind of expecting Rave to actually take the Faceless Void first overall. So I don't know if they just feel really comfortable against the hero, but I think a lot of teams you would see ban out the Batrider or the Faceless Void over top of the Batrider, I think, if they were worried about it. So it's kind of interesting.
No.
Not too shocking to see the Brood banned out. Both of these teams willing to run it.
I think the other hero you ban, maybe Beastmaster.
10 seconds.
Or
Any attack speed aura for sure. Yeah. Just making sure that this OD is going to have a rougher time, and then remaining. I'm sure our Svens will be coming into play as well.
Which means Invoker will still be left in the pool if TNC want to try and get their hands on that third pick and then run a safe lane OD.
Radiant team.
That's just a thought.
Yeah, especially against the Faceless Void, right? Like, this is one of the best scenarios to actually go for it. You already have the Witch Doctor, which isn't one of the best supports against the Faceless Void. Typically, you're thinking more about your Lions, your Disruptors, someone that can help you get on some secure damage, either through damage over time or big lockdown. But okay, well, that's also fair. Banning out the Lone Druid instead. So I definitely think that Beastmaster is the pick here for TNC. There's no other top tier offlaner left. You're on the Dire side. You're giving the attack speed aura over to your OD. It's like maximum synergy in every single way. So it only comes down to player preference at this point.
10 seconds remaining. TNC, meanwhile, what would they be afraid of? If they plan on third picking the Invoker here, let's just theory crap that out, right? Third pick Invoker, fourth pick Beastmaster, because Rave don't really have a spot for it unless they're going to jungle. Then they could probably ban away, what, the other mid that would do okay against OD would be like the Zeus, but they just go with the synergy heroes that work with the Faceless Void, and that obviously makes a lot of sense. They're going to ban away the Gyrocopter carry, and we'll see. Beastmaster, Invoker. I don't think they need to worry about the Beastmaster right now. I just highly doubt Rave is going to pick it up. They go for the four-position Doom, maybe?
Team pick.
Pretty good at being able to initiate on Void and lock him out of the fight. But they are going to be facing a Drow Ranger push strategy here, which could include a Visage fourth pick.
Ooh, okay. So this is some very interesting stuff coming up from them. And they're actually going to go right for the Viper. All right, so mid lane secured. Drow Aura and Viper. That seems pretty damn good, even if it's going to be the OD. All backed up by a Faceless Void. Okay, Raver's starting to open up into something here, but the question is now, TNC, how are they going to punish it? Do you want to do some sort of a dual offlane with your Doom? Can you find some other hero to work alongside that? Can you do it with the Beastmaster still? Remaining. What kind of a setup do you need for the Spectre and OD?
Reserve time.
I think in this game, you run an offlane Doom. I just don't really see another offlaner working out, and I don't see another offlaner being fast enough. Unless you pick up something that's like a little bit different, say like the Tusk or Earthshaker offlaner or something that harkens back to older patches. I don't think any other offlane is going to be able to deal with a Drow Ranger Tri-lane very well, and very likely just to be too slow.
Enigma seems good here, actually. Now, yeah, I think you're right. Like, with that Doom offlane, they could go into something like, because now you get rid of the Visage too, which obviously would have been nice with the Drow Ranger, but they don't have the best heroes for dealing with Enigma right now. I mean, it's kind of scary with the Faceless Void, but I guess you'd have to get yourselves a Blink, so. It is a little bit of a tough game here. They would have really liked something like that Chenner Enchantress at this point, I think, for TNC.
10 seconds remaining.
Obviously, your Spectre, like, you have the Haunt on top of the Drow, one of the best things. So they're just going to, like, mega secure that offlane and try and put pressure on the Drow.
Yeah, and a big armor increase and such. Rave going to go for... I mean, there weren't too many supports left that I think would have changed this lineup in any significant way. So they go with a support that actually does a decent amount of physical damage. A lot of right clicks from the Lina thanks to that that passive. I like the way the TNC has responded to this. As soon as they realize, okay, it's a Drone Ranger strat, they pick up the Spectre to close that gap. They get the Lich for securing the lane. I think all around this is the best they could have done, but... Rave is still in a position where they could just outright win the game again by 15-20 minutes.
Yeah, I'm really interested to see how this Doom is going to be interacting early on. Doom and Lich, there definitely is some kill potential, a little bit of a, you know, rundown here coming in from that Dire side. It definitely seems like they have the easier game this time on the side of Rave, just in terms of like what you expect these heroes to do in the laning phase and then what coming out of that. Whereas the Spectre, certainly, yeah, it really is the same. Like, if they can delay this out a little while and not do too poorly in the laning stage, as we saw Rave get totally dumpstered by that lineup of TNC last game, then you can definitely see them making some sort of a comeback. But again, it should be a little bit difficult for the OD to get off that maximum potential. You don't have the Faceless Void, you don't have the AoE stuns or setups. It's going to be very single target focused for now.
I guess this is the best opportunity TNC has to prove unequivocally that they are the better team, right? They win with the push strategy, and if they can defeat Rave's push strategy with kind of a very similar, slower lineup that Rave had last game, then... they'll prove they're kind of the best in both worlds.
Yeah, a lot of this, to me, it seems like it might actually come down to AU and Winergy Smallsun and these ultimates. Like, how are you going to get any value out of Chain Frost this game? And how are you going to get value out of your Death Ward? They, again, just don't have the heroes that set up for this whatsoever. Mm-hmm. It basically has to be Kask. Like, that's your AoE stun right now. And we've had heroes like struggle with this earlier today and actually getting value out. Like, yeah, it's great. You still have the Voodoo Restoration, but it's Death Ward, you know?
I would have liked Wyvern. I think Wyvern would have been the should have been the pickup for TNC. Lich.
A little bit of repositioning.
Yeah, there's some good things about Lich in that, you know, you're able to run a dual lane, but I still don't think this hero is going to be enough to win this for TNC. But guess we'll have to see. An important part is really trying to shut down the Faceless Void as much as possible. Make sure he doesn't get a fast Vlad's into Blink Dagger. Vlad's is going to be a big upgrade in damage and survivability for Rave. Obviously, both the lifesteal and the armor is pretty important here. But also... that Blink Dagger initiation is going to be the way that Rave kind of secures the game. Now, this level one fight is actually going to be pretty important here. TNC, they're fighting 4v5, but they've already almost lost Teehee. He pops the Fairy Fire, will be able to pick up the Banning Rune, and he actually almost gets away, but still, they got the first blood first onto the Drow Ranger. Nice double stun there with the LSA, but they're going to be able to catch Derp next. This actually works out really well for TNC. 3-for-1. And they still got the Bounty Rune. The OD is able to get back into lane, no problem. And I'm not sure why he's even checking top, because Faceless Void definitely secured that one already.
Yeah, I guess had to take the Pika to hope, you know. And so he comes in, it ends up being relatively even, but Rior will be a half level down. So that's actually pretty huge. Once the passive starts coming more into play, though, from Jao, I'm sure he'll be able to battle his way right back into this lane. Top solo faces Void. As suspected, it'll just be the Witch Doctor here. So a nice early pair of boots will be great for Winergy Small Summon. He actually ended up with 2 kills from that engagement, so that's going to be perfect for him to actually try and harass out this Void.
I wonder what made them decide that they could fight Rave at level 1. Because they don't have a great level 1 lineup, to be honest.
No.
They have 2 heroes that are actually very bad at level 1, traditionally. Lich as well as Doom, because both their abilities are not combat abilities. But you can see Sam H went for the Scorcher just because it was so necessary to win that fight.
Yeah, I don't know. And you really expect Lina. She's like numero uno in terms of the bounty rune fights. I think every single time you almost always see Lina win out those just through the LSA and obviously solid damage, solid stun, big AoE.
Rior thinks he can win this man fight against Teehee, but he's really not. In fact, he may die to this last hit. Fairy Fire plus an uphill miss means that he will be able to get away. But that was pretty close. That was pretty scary. I think if OD had
AU?
Prism? He's dead.
Oh my god, that was a lot of damage. Wow. Thank you, Minus Armor.
Sam H is probably dead too. Can't dodge the LSA. Scorched Earth only just now coming up, but I think it's too late. Nukes from Lina are able to finish him off, and that definitely evens out the game, not only just in score, but obviously the laning phase is looking good now for Rave. This bottom lane.
Yeah, Jao gets to do what he loves doing, and just keep hitting creeps while his supports handle everything else. 2 points now up into Precision Aura. And so at least like Rior, the fact that he survived, trying to keep this mid lane relatively even. But Rappy's still doing okay up top. Still very hard for him to force him out.
Yeah. Witch Doctor is definitely not the hero to do that. Though few solo supports are. Meanwhile, yeah. AU is going to be spending more time in mid lane, it seems, while our Doom should, I think, full-time jungle. This is part of the reason I wanted to see offlane Doom. Get a hero that can just leave the lane, because you're probably going to need it. Did Doom holding off on a level here?
Yeah, it looks that way. Guess he's not sure if they were going to be fighting again or what, or he'll have a time to like go for the Devour or something, probably.
Yeah. Also, the Infernal Blade is super strong, but obviously it's not going to do much if you're just being run at by 3 ranged heroes kiting you, so maybe he figures if he's in real trouble, he needs Scorched Earth.
Is this going to be the bootless Viper mech build? I've seen this a couple times from SEA games. So far, he's just rocking the ring.
Is that a thing? Is that a build?
Yeah, it's like the airship Viper or something. You just like slowly walk in and you're unkillable.
It doesn't even go brown boots?
I've seen bootless. I've seen like 0 brown boots.
Wow.
Yeah, it's like Huskar, you know, getting that early armlet with nothing else.
Smoke wrap around here on the mid lane. They are going to run into Teehee, but unfortunately for them, they're not able to grab the right one. Teehee very smartly doesn't try and cut back into the mid lane early. He goes his full wraparound. Ninja Boogie is going to try and keep him zoned out entirely as the 2 Rave supports make sure there's no easy access to the mid lane, bottom lane. Jao, oh! Paralyzing Cask bounces right back to him, stopping that TP.
The punish, man. Good play by TNC.
Yeah,
see,
very good.
Supports are AFK, I guess AFL, away from lane. Nice, nailed it.
Good work.
don't ever let them tell you that a BA is useless, guys.
All Teehee had to do was make sure he didn't die from those 2 supports. Happy times. May still die to these supports, though. Not quite enough damage.
First phase, Witch Doctor boys. Winergy Smallson putting this hero to work. Oh, look at him handing the ward over too. What a support player, what a nice guy.
Now all they need to do is secure the rune for OD. Refill that bottle.
Raven's getting farmed, dude. He's building up into that urn. Doom's even second place. He's having the time of his life.
Yeah, he really is. The power of Devour. Maxed
damn,
out.
Man,
for
we're on fire. That was good.
Just doing all rhyming cast. Thrilla in Manila. Power of Devour. Uh-oh. Lich? Well, there's a rhyme with Lich, but I don't think I want to say it in a professional broadcast. But AU is dead like a dog. Let's put it that way. Maybe if you didn't quite figure out what the rhyme was with Lich.
Got him. All right, Riora has the boots. Everything's right in the world. There isn't Infus Rune on Teehee, so did. All right, what did he just fairy out? I think he just fairied out branches. But all right, that's
yeah,
super
man.
Intense.
Gotta get them stats.
You know, that's like when you're sitting in another lane, you're just waiting for the courier, and you're like, dude, seriously? You're bringing branches? Like, I have my urn done here. Which, yeah, Raven is actually closing in on, but. Here comes the smoke. They'll get the Invis Rune to help lead it up too, so they can set up perfectly. And I can only imagine they would love to bring down Jao once more as he's building into the Helm of the Dominator, but Doom won't be available for this one. Oh,
no, they don't get it.
She is TP.
Gasket. Oh, Fairy Fire forces Teehee to actually throw out another hit. Still, though, the Spectre's instantly going to be jumping on to Jao, so they might be able to get some revenge for the OD. There's no LSA to stop this. Raven just continues to stay on Jao. He's taking the extra damage now, too. The Paralyzing Cast going to bounce around. Now he can turn on Ninja Boogie if he really wanted to, but Raven just wants to back himself away. Smart, too. The Viper was almost there. Rappy hoping for a bash. Gets it, too. 10 magic stick charges, though. Winter G. He was baiting that one. He's like, go ahead.
Red swaps.
Yeah.
So sad right now, Rappy, please. Oh, that was perfect timing, though. Raven had the urn just finished, so he gets that nice 2 charges. Okay, I played Dota for, like, almost 3 years before realizing that you got 2 charges on the urn when it was at 0.
Thank oh, really?
You. Thank you, everyone. Yeah, I don't know how I never noticed that, but yo. I just noticed it like a couple months ago.
See, this is what I'm saying, all right? Whenever your teammates flame, I hate the opposition to urns. Like, if it happens, if it just happens to be a good stat item, and you have 2 gankers on the opposite side of the map, like, what's the problem, man, with double urn? Because there is so much efficiency if you actually split kills and you get 4 urn charges out of it. It's so cool.
That's true. That's mega worth. That's like a full tower of like urn charges, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, how many times have you seen you know, somebody with too many urn charges? They just like doesn't get the opportunity to use it. Yeah, it happens a lot. There's not that many issues with splitting your urn charges, man. Rior right, might be taken out here for the duo. Oh, the paralyzing cask from downtown!
Oh my god, it actually saves them.
Oh god, or maybe it baits Teehee into a death.
Alright, more so that.
Yeah, Viper still ends up dying though. That's pretty important.
Man, that was like the dream. So close. If only they knew about the cask. Could've just manned up there. Oh, hot? Derp? Goodbye.
Look at it go.
Third urn charge online. I don't know, man. Raven, as well as Sam H, they're topping that chart. They're looking pretty big. It's much more evenly split amongst the next 4 heroes on the Radiant, though. And our OD, he's lacking. And now, typically, I'm okay with this. Like, your OD, oh, they can fight back. All they need is a single fight. They just steal some int, press R, life's good. But they don't have the heroes to let them do that. Like, not only do they not have mega defensive heroes like an Oracle that actually frees you up, like, yeah, they have heals, but that's not going to stop stuns, right? Like, Teehee's still going to be locked in place even if he's alive. And there's no big AoE setup to actually let him get his stuff going, so he just needs, like, a really fortuitous mistake almost from the side of Rave. There's not actually anything that can allow him to flourish himself. He's going to have to, like, go bail.
There's the Chrono. Ninja Boogie comes in with the LSA. They have the Laguna Blade as well. We'll be able to execute the Spectre. So nice rotation there from Rave. They needed something like that to slow her down as she's getting just a bit too much.
Yeah.
Oh, the Imprison.
Oh, they got it. Wow.
But can they actually kill him, though?
No. It's way too long.
Rior is really scary, guys. OD is a pretty good hero, well, in some ways, against Viper. He offers pure damage against that magic defense. The problem being that there's an attack speed slow innately to Viper, which really screws the OD's damage as well. So kind of.
Oh, is Ninja Boogie tanking the gank?
Bye, Ninja Boogie. Wait, what? Where did Sam H go? Why did he dip down? That was weird.
I guess trying to avoid like a three-man LSA or something.
Yeah, I guess.
Either way, that means no wave clear here. It's pretty much only all on Lina here. This is really
Oh, why are they doing this? All right, Spectre ult's going to go down. He's going to buy himself some time. Rappy doesn't have a Chronosphere. Teehee comes back, and oh, he's living until he's not. He dropped the ultimate, though, and that might be good enough still to win this fight because there's no mana on Rappy. They might still be able to run him down, but they're out of mana, too, so never mind. One for two exchange, though.
Jayo's just, like, gone, though. Running into their juggle here.
Jay was just like, what the fuck? What's going on, guys? You're diving our tier 2s. We can't punish them. How's this happening?
Teehee's just like a sponge. Just gonna run forward and hope they focus me because I'm a big, scary, overpowered hero, but I actually do nothing right now. I'm lower than my witch doctor.
That is, oh my god, he's so low on the net worth.
Dude, he's so poor. All right, he eclipsed the Lich. Take that. Oh, wow. Wait till I get one more last hit. I'll be above my support Witch Doctor. Oh, there we go. Oh no, he's still not.
Wow. If Winter G was actually last hitting a little bit better, he'd stay ahead, but. Rappy, ready to go with the Chronos here. It's part of the problem. Oh! Got up! Arnett. Happy.
He's not happy enough for that one. It. I need bigger heroes.
Guess
like
so.
That OD.
Or the Doombringer.
Real firm, scary ones.
You don't get much bigger in actual size than the Doom. In this game, at least.
Looks like he's heading into probably the Vlads now after the drums. I mean, pretty standard stuff. Don't know if he needs the blink quite yet. It's going to be sick, though, when he actually gets it. Like, there's going to be a Spectre Haunt, and then you can immediately Haunt on top of Jayo, and then you're going to be giving Vision right on top of Rappy. So then he's just going to blink and doom him. And that's pretty super scary. Then it's just on Rior, basically, to stand there and try and kill everyone who comes in.
Vlad's almost up for Rappy. He's had a great game so far. He's third on the network chart. You're going to go for a five-man smoke. Still have holding on to that Chronosphere. And now it's time to actually loose that bad boy.
I think that was good that he held it. Since the tower was already secured, I feel like they need to close out more of these objectives right now. And it's actually going to be Roshan. Okay, all right. Obviously, Drow lineup. Easy gaming, but they're ready for this from TNC. They have the Haunt up, they have the Death Ward, they have the Sandy's Eclipse. This is the fight that can bring Teehee back into the game.
But they maybe still be too grouped up for the Chronosphere. Let's see. Spectre Ultimate goes down. Rappy sitting on the side, ready to go with the Chrono! Latches down for the Paralyzing Cast is stopping some of this damage, though. Now the Chain Frost comes in, bounces over to Rappy, though. That's a lucky save there. Rave, swap back. Oh no, Rior, not the swap he really needed. He's now facing up against the Spectre who will get him killed. Derp goes down as well. Paralyzing Cast, MVP.
Oh my god. All right, I'm sure TNC have it all figured out now. First pick Witch Doctor every game. Winter G's Vault's on his hacks going on or something.
Yeah, he really does.
I actually cannot believe they just 4-1 that fight. How? How is that even possible?
Yeah, they doomed a Faces Void after Chrono. They got 4-man Chronosphered. with only the Spectre putting out damage during that time, and he wasn't even getting Desolate damage because the enemy was all grouped up. It makes no sense that they managed to win that fight, but Paralyzing Cask, man, it's a strong ability.
Like, a four-hero chrono, a drow lineup, they were all free to right-click, and then Cask is just like, Doctor is in, baby. But look at Winnergy, his cojones are so huge right now, his coconuts. He's just walking through the Radiant Jungle. He doesn't even care. He's like, that's right, I'm the big boy. I got 1,300 gold. I'm going into an Aether Lens.
If you put him on Showcase View and you listen real closely, you can still hear the sound of those coconuts banging between his legs as he walks around.
I believe it.
Boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, you guys are welcome for the free workshop set. Arditz is out there.
For only $9.99, you can buy Witch Doctor Balls.
Could have them, like, attached to a bottle opener at TI in the secret shop. All right, Invis Rune, free kill. I don't know. He's kind of tanky.
Yeah,
he's
this is not ages. This is not so free.
What?
Okay.
Why did you wait?
I don't know.
Okay, there was, like, a lich right there, too. Even he's pretty tanky, though.
Aether Lens already for the Witch Doctor. Holy cow. $5,200. OD has made the great ascent from support to carry. He has.
That's impressive.
He has. That fight did him wonders.
I had to rewatch that cast. That was amazing. Oh, good stuff.
Easy time.
Man, he's rocking a full wand too. Energy smells, and he's just unkillable right now. He's gonna bait them in.
Yeah, man.
They have lost all momentum from Wraith. I mean, we were at the point where it was like, Chrono's up, let's waltz on in and grab whatever we'd like. And now suddenly OD's a hero again. He has an Aegis, he has drums. He's basically where he exactly wants to be as an OD. That's so ridiculous considering his position not even 3 minutes ago.
This lineup's gonna get even harder to kill soon if they can complete the mech on AU. He's got the buckler already. The ice armor. Oh my god, what the hell? 30 armor on Doom?
They said armor was my weakness.
Holy crap! Yes, ice armor for himself plus ice armor from Lich. That's 15 armor by itself. That is one way to deal with the drone lineup right there. Look at him try to lay into Sam H. He just doesn't care. Now you're all doomed, you fools. The Lich. It's bouncing around the Chain Frost. It's like a Blinko Ball. It just doesn't stop. Oh my god. They just wiped four. Rappy's running away with Doom still on him. Fortunately, he found a Haze Druid, so free escape. But what the hell, TNC?
Damn.
Destroyed Rave.
That was like the most perfect time to point that out. That armor, man. Totally unkillable. No hope whatsoever. And at the start of game number one, we looked at the lineups and we said, all right, TNC have made themselves a window. They have an opportunity where as long as they don't screw up, they should pretty much win this game. And I think Rave built the exact same thing this game. I think the way they were matched up against the heroes on TNC, it was looking really good. But the clean execution and like the running of the strat, just not there, obviously. Like the Roshan fight was the first part, but now falling apart at these tower defenses is... And we build more and more farm up onto a Spectre and an Dyer's OD, it's obviously not going to start looking any better. Dyer's bottom
tower is under attack. 2,700 gold on the OD. Gonna get a BKB soon. Actually, I think Blink Dagger is better in this game. I'm not sure. BKB doesn't offer that much for the OD. But if he has Blink Dagger and he's really fast, Rappy. Okay, doesn't manage to get the tower. I think that Malajinx is like literally doing no damage per tick. Because he undid the damage that was done before he got hit by the Malajinx, so it was like he got healed.
Yeah, Maledict's one of those weird spells because it checks every time. So if you ever heal back up to past where you were, then it does no damage. But yeah. Oh, Maledict. What's Sam building? What is this? Oh, what do we have here? A little Vit booster.
Crimson Guard against a Drow Ranger lineup?
I would have to say so.
Gotta all the auras, dude, man.
You just build whatever you want.
They're literally just building, like, mass physical damage survivability. As much armor as possible. Gonna get some damage block in here.
I'm kind of surprised with how farmed he is that he's not just going straight for his Shivas. He must be leaving it for Teehee.
Yeah, maybe. Man, with the OD around, he never runs out of mana either.
All right, is this it? Is this the recovery play? Look where the OD is, as well maybe. As Winter, though.
Sam H has a problem. He only has one ice armor. This will be his real weakness. Oh, the save! Laguna Blade dodged by the imprisonment. Sam H has time to get off the doom with the Chain Frostmaster. Call it, Rave. Tap out now. This fight is done. And so is this game. TNC, they just... Oh, God. There's not a word to describe that massacre. Woo!
All right, underrated aspect of Blink Dagger OD.
Yeah.
Coming into play right there. Man, TNC just read that like a book. They were so ready for that, it wasn't even funny. It was like the most clear bait I've ever watched from a spectator perspective. Teehee just chilling in the trees like, oh yeah, they're coming. There's a smoke coming. Look at their lane in mid, it's pushing in, there's no one there. Yeah, they're coming.
Ooh, all right. Tier 1, Tier 2, both gonna be falling here, I believe, without Chronosphere. I don't think Rave can stand against TNC in a defensive fight. Dire's middle tower is under attack. You could already see the Vipers like, nope, I'm pushing out bottom, guys. Radiant's
top tower is nice click for it as well.
Dagger through. Derp is indeed a freebie. Free intelligence for Teehee to soak up. Under 9 to 25, 23 minutes in, all of a sudden, it has just been a free fall. It's like at one point in time, Rave, they're walking along this path, you know, having a good time in the game, ready to execute their push lineup, and then they tripped. And then they rolled down the hill, and they just never stopped. The momentum just kept them tumbling and tumbling and tumbling.
I mean, we saw like how far behind the OD was, but the thing is, this was a Drow lineup, and you look at these five heroes, and then you look at this graph, and you're expecting that at the very least, it should have been moving in an upward position from like 0 to almost 15 minutes, right? You're thinking, very nice early game. We're gonna go ahead. We're gonna close out this map. Everything's gonna be, you know, just perfecto. But that's not how it went. It was just relatively even the whole time. And if you can't actually increase that gap to when you're getting to the point where these mega heroes come online between OD and Spectre, I mean, this is what you expect to come about.
He already has mech, and he's now getting a medallion. There's more armor, more.
What do you think he gets up to? What's the over-under on this? Like...
I mean, we're going to have...
a chance it makes 50.
Oh, yeah. We're going to have one hero that gets 50 armor. Like, almost guaranteed. Like, Spectre naturally has high armor because she's an agility hero. So, you put the double armor items on her, the ice armor and the ice armor. You should probably be naming them a little bit differently, Valve. But you put both of those on the on this Spectre. You had the Vlads on him as well. That already probably gets you up to, like, mid-30s.
We should rename the aura from Shiva as, like, Armor of Ice. That would just be perfect.
Yeah, really, it should be Ice Armor and Frost Armor. Though that should be the two difference here between the Ogre Magi and the Lich Armor. Come on, Valve. Hire me. I'll do this.
Seriously, now you got all the great ideas today. All right, so how do we do this as Rave? What's up here? We got our Blink Chrono. Let's say, theoretical, five-man Blink Chrono. Do they even have enough damage? They really don't. Like, because you guarantee there's no way Crimson Guard doesn't get popped. It's definitely impossible. It's going to get popped before the chrono goes off. I don't think they can kill anyone. Maybe winner. Maybe. And then you chrono and focus all five right clicks onto a Witch Doctor.
39, 45 armor. 45. He just needs five more. So if he gets an Eagle Song, that'll be 50.
Oh, no.
Jump in. Oh, I can't move the camera fast enough. J.O. Gonna be jumped on. Looks like they're already cleaning up. Yeah, Derp's gonna be next in line.
All right, tap out. It's over.
I was about to say, there's an addendum here. If Rave just call it right now, you know, that's a little unfair.
That is true.
Ah! They call it. 16-minute game with an early push lineup. 26-minute game with a late game lineup. TNC show unequivocally that right now they are the better Filipino team and they deserve to move on to the semifinals.
Damn. I mean, I gotta say, I was not expecting this. TNC, I just agree. You can try and justify it, call it a cheese draft, call it a push strat or something the first time, but this time they just straight up outplayed Rave. Couldn't quite get their lineup rolling. The Doom Lich Man, that went much better than I had anticipated. And honestly, yeah, they got a little lucky with the casks in both games, but Winergy Small's fun. You know, you can control some of that RNG. You don't just luckily end up 4-0 and 22 as a Witch Doctor. So major props to that guy.
Yeah, that was pretty insane. TNC, looking hot. Maybe this is their qualifier. Maybe this is the qualifier that they are able to actually take in one of these major tournaments. They've done well before in the past, but haven't quite cinched the deal. We'll see. Fnatic's still the big raid boss. Their match is going to be tomorrow, starting 11 CEST, Fnatic versus Execration, followed up by Signature Trust versus MVP Phoenix. I hope you guys will join us for those matches. Modpax will not because he's going on vacation.
Woo.
Have some fun, buddy. Do you have any last words before you go off to Mexico?
No, I'm gone for like a week, guys. Don't forget about me. I'll come back eventually, I swear. Unless, right, you know, they actually get good casters by then I won't. So keep me in mind. Follow me on Twitter, at Mopax. Follow this guy, the Dota Capitalist. Y'all know who he is.
All right. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll be back. More matches today. Both Durka and Toby are coming into the studio. Join Dota. Should have all your updates.